Hey guys, so some of you asked about my braces when I got them on and wanted to know how they felt and just had a few questions on what I personally thought about them. So I figured I'd make this video for you guys who requested it. I did get my braces on, I believe, in August or September. And I know I am halfway through with my braces. The months go by super fast. I believe if things go as planned, these should be off by December of 2014, which I really look forward to. But then again, I've kind of fallen in love with these braces. I don't know why, but I guess they just kind of grew on me. Here's a before picture of what my teeth look like. My husband and some of my friends actually told me that I never did need braces and they thought it looked fine. I don't know if you guys think that. As for me, I personally didn't like the way my teeth were and I didn't really care for my overbite. I didn't have insurance for getting braces. I did have insurance before when I was under 18 and I should have took that opportunity up. But for some reason in high school, I thought, oh, I don't need braces. I'm fine. My teeth is fine. And now, you know, looking back, I wish I got it done back then. Overall, these braces cost me about $7,000 out of the pocket. I think it was $8,000. $7,000 to $8,000 for these braces. And I paid straight up out of the pocket. So it's really a big investment. Also, I was a good candidate for Invisalign, but I decided to go with braces because Invisalign wouldn't have corrected my overbite, and also on the sides of this side, my teeth wasn't crisscrossing over correctly. Instead, they're sitting on each other, which isn't right. So that is why I went with braces, because braces would have been the only thing that would have corrected the way my teeth were situated. So now I see that my teeth on the sides are now zigzagged like that rather than sitting parallel to each other. One of the most popular questions you guys asked was, when I got my braces, how did they feel on and was I self-conscious about it? Well, I'm gonna be very honest with you guys. When I did get my braces, I did feel a little bit self-conscious, and at the same time too, having like these brackets and wires in my mouth, it felt really uncomfortable. I felt like I didn't know how to talk. I felt like I had a slur as well, because it's just like having these objects in my mouth just made it seem so awkward. When I smiled, I was a little bit more self-conscious about it. As a couple months went by, I was really surprised as how fast I adapted to the braces, as far as like eating, smiling, feeling confident about wearing my braces. And now I'm not self-conscious about my braces at all. I think the only concern I have is while I'm eating, that if I get some food particles stuck between my braces and I'm talking to somebody, I always wonder, is there something stuck in my bracket? But to get through that, I usually just joke around with my friends and ask them, do I have anything stuck in my teeth, in my braces? Or even ask my husband that, and they don't mind. They just tell you. You know, I just think if you get braces, you should totally rep it and enjoy it. It's just going to be for a short amount of time during your life, and it's totally worth it. Another thing that you guys asked me is if braces hurt. My braces did hurt. The first time they put them on, the first week was so painful. I couldn't eat anything. I had to either like drink soups or smoothies. Then again, it was the beginning of me having braces. Things were really crooked. My overbite was more deeper. So it's like it took a lot of adjusting that first week. And I was surprised within 2 weeks, my teeth became completely straight. I was really shocked at how straight it became, and I thought I was ready to take those braces off and not even wear them after the second week. If you guys are wondering the type of braces that I got, these are the Damon brand ones. Yes, there are different types of braces out there. The old school ones are usually the ones where you see like the colorful rubber bands on the teeth around the brackets and such. For the Damon brackets, you don't have any rubber bands around each bracket. Instead, it's just the bracket by itself along with the wire. So I'll show you guys right here, if you can see. So these are the brackets. And then, of course, this is obviously the wire. So you can see there is absolutely no bands around the brackets. And I think hygienically wise, it's a lot more easier to take care of. Since I'm talking about the rubber bands, the only bands that I've been using is to correct my overbite. And what it does is it attaches to the upper and lower part of my my teeth. When they first started me off, I was using a thinner wire and a very small rubber band. And these ones are called Quail, are a lot thinner than the ones that I'm using now. Here's a close-up of the rubber band. And it's really tiny and they're really stretchy and they never did snap in my mouth while I would be talking and stuff. But during the times that I ate, I would have to remove them so that I wouldn't swallow them. Sometimes, even though I go for a routine checkup, I don't always change the bands. So around the second time that I went for my routine checkup, they switched out my wire and they also replaced my bands with the rabbit bands. They're a little bit more thicker. I believe they're the same size as the quails, just thicker in size. And then the third time I went, they kept me on the same bands, which were the rabbits. But recently, they finally changed me out to a thicker rubber band. And these ones are called the Buffalo bands. And as you can tell, they are a lot more wider, bigger in size, and a lot more thicker. It seems like it has more give on the band, but it's a lot more thicker, so it will pull more. And the reason why it's wider, it's because they just moved the area where I was attaching my bands. One was on the bottom back here and one was on the top this way. So they're at an angle. And now what they did is they just moved this one up closer to the front of my teeth. Which after they did that, I was like, oh my God, this is so obvious. You can see my bands now when I talk and smile. So it took me a while to get used to it. But yeah, so now they're sitting right here in the two front. And then they attached to the back here. Along with that, they did change out my wire again to a thicker wire. Each time I go, they keep changing out my wires to a thicker size. As far as cleaning wise goes, they gave me a pick and I just use floss, and the pick helps like thread through my teeth so I can get in between each teeth and floss. It's really not that bad. I really think because of the Damon braces that I went with, it's a lot more easier to care for and clean. It's not as tedious as other braces. All in all, if you're somebody who's looking to get braces, I think getting braces is actually a good solution if you're self-conscious about your teeth or if they're really crooked or you're having jaw problems. I think braces really fixes that problem. Also, if you're somebody who has braces, you know, don't be ashamed of it, because, you know, I had a couple girls who actually asked me, like, if I was ashamed of it, because they were kind of, you know, shy about having their braces on. But it's really not that bad at all. You know, feel comfortable in your skin. And, you know, these braces are just going to be on for a little while, so it's really not that bad. What I highly suggest for those of you who are considering braces is to get consultations with different orthodontists. Find somebody that you feel comfortable with, someone that you could trust will get the job done as to straightening your teeth. And also ask them what kind of braces do they use, you know, because there are different brands out there. And the Damon brackets, I absolutely love them. And I love the new technology of these braces. And also, they come in white ceramic too. I forgot to mention that. So, you know, if you're conscious about having the silver on your teeth, you can go with the white and you can't see it. But then the silver is a lot more stronger than the ceramic. Sometimes the ceramic could break off or crack and such. So I didn't want to even deal with that. And besides, I felt that these braces were pretty minimal compared to the other braces that I've seen out there. It wasn't so bulky. But anyways, I hope you guys found this video informative for you, and I hope I answer most of your guys' questions about my braces. Yeah, it's kind of a weird topic video to do and such, but anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and yeah, see you guys later.